Playoffs. Right, I've got the clip slack. I'm just going to twist the pipe to just to crack it off. You want to dribble out? Now we can reach the back one. Nice and slack. Again, just give the pipe a twist just to crack it off. And see if I can push this one off. Here we go. And I bet that's stuck. Oh, it's not too bad. Oh. It's touching the bottom, so it's a bit awkward. There you go. And the pipe's off. Right, two engine mounts. That one, engine mount. And that engine mount. And barrel's off. And that's it, engine can come out. Right, just before I take the engine right out, I'm going to pull this pinion off. It's a pinion puller. Now you find there's not much room in between the case, so you'll grind the touch off the edge just to make them jaws a little thinner, then they'll go in. Right, I want the nose of the crank protecting. I'm going to use a brass screw and a washer. These are not usually that tight, so shouldn't have much of a problem. Right. Let's get that in there. Nice and tight so it grips. And a spanner on the end. Is it moving? Finger tight that it's moving. Gonna have a check, see what's happening. Oops. Yeah, it's moving out nice that. What's wrong with it? And there's the pinion. Should be. And I don't know whether you can see, there's the dot. Right. Now the engine bolts. Right, I'm just slacking the engine mounts off. That's that one. Shot me daft exhaust hanger away. Yeah. A bit of a tap. And you're gonna come out alright. Lovely. Right. Just gonna whip the barrels off. Just go in there with a bit of cloth. And let's see what these little ends are like. We'll see. Right, I'm just going to give these a pull. Feels nice and solid, that one, like. Little end in that one, definitely. Yeah, as I thought, this Conrod's knackered. I bet the little end slid out again. Shove them down. Right, with a bit of luck, this engine should lift out. I wonder if I should put a jack under it. Just to take a bit of weight off the bottom mount. Spaces will drop out of it, I would have thought. Pull that out from this side. One. A couple of spacers. That's about it. Right, I'm going to lift the engine and turn it round, and it comes out on the left hand side. So let's see where I'm going to go. Stuck on these spacers at the bottom. There she is. Right. And onto this side. And there's a Bonneville without an engine in it. Right, we're going to split the crankcases. And then once it's a bit, I'll give it a good clean off. And I'll have a look at what bits are wrong with it. Left hand conrod. That's what I reckon. Right, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 on this side. So I'll just crack these off. studs are turning. I'll have to get a spanner on the back. I must admit, I prefer wiping off the floor. In my hand, that's slack. And that's like when I can get it. And then to a slack. Right, come on the other side. Be careful when you're knocking it side to side, because the studs will whack on the floor. Right, I'll crack up this side now. So, there's one at the back of the barrel here, one at the front, and one at the back here. So I'll just crack these off, these. Lovely. That one. Lovely. And that one. Stiff that one, squirty purdy. If a bolt is a bit stiff on the way out, don't just keep winding it out. Wind it back in a touch and work the thread, because sometimes it's just a bit of muck or something gathers up on the thread. But if it's too severe and you just keep winding, it can drag the thread out the alloy. I'll just turn that motor around again. Right, I'll just rip the rest off. think that's about it. Yep. This is about ready to come out now. Split 'em. Let's see what happens with a couple of taps. Let's have a look. Enough crankcase, that come apart very nice and easy. Loved it, love it. Right, pop that over here on the floor. Right, I'm going to take the rods off here now. Take this rod off anyway. I have a funny feeling these big ends will be down to the copper.